The next part of the setup is managing the chart of accounts. When I say managing the chart of accounts, I mean deleting, editing, or adding an account. We know that the chart of accounts is the same thing as the general ledger. The little picture you have here is Holden's chart of accounts. Remember, if it's a different type of company, the account names will be different because a different company runs differently and therefore needs a different set of accounts to record their transactions in. When we created the file in the previous video, we clicked Help Me Choose for the industry type. The reason we did that is because QuickBooks wants us to choose what type of company we have. This is because QuickBooks wants to put a chart of accounts for us. If we chose a different industry, we would need a different set of accounts in our chart of accounts. So QuickBooks thought it was helping us by allowing us to choose the type of company, and then QuickBooks would prepare a chart of accounts for us. If you remember, the choice that we made was other, none. That was because we wanted to put the accounts ourselves in order to learn it better. Therefore, we chose other, none because we did not want QuickBooks to put in any of the accounts. We wanted to put the accounts ourselves from what we know about our business. And that's what we're about to do right now. From the main menu, click List, Chart of Accounts, and the Chart of Accounts window opens up. This is the window that you will use to add, delete, or edit any of the accounts in the Chart of Accounts. Notice that QuickBooks already put four accounts in the Chart of Accounts for us. QuickBooks did this even though we chose other, none. Even though we told QuickBooks we want to put the accounts ourselves and we don't want QuickBooks to put in a sample chart of accounts, QuickBooks will still put in these four accounts. Now, we don't need them and we can try to remove them or try to make them inactive if necessary. The way to do that, the way to remove or edit an account that's already on the list, is to right-click. Now, when you right-click on one of the accounts, you get a submenu that allows you to edit, delete, or make an account inactive. Deleting an account means the account is gone forever. Making an account inactive means it's still there, but it's hidden. We're going to try to delete the accounts that QuickBooks put so we could start fresh and put our own accounts. If we cannot delete the account, we will simply make it inactive. So let's try to remove the accounts that we don't want. We don't have payroll liabilities, so let's right-click and click Delete. Okay, QuickBooks will not let us delete this one. Try the next one. Right-click, Delete. Click OK. It's gone. Right-click, Delete. Click OK. It's gone. Right-click, Delete. Okay, these two accounts QuickBooks will not allow us to delete. No problem. We can make them inactive. Right-click, Make Account Inactive. That means it's hidden. Right-click, Make Account Inactive. That means it's hidden. Now, you should also know that in addition to the right-click, you can also click the bottom left button. The bottom left button of the list window has similar options when there are accounts up here. So if you wanted to show the inactive accounts, you would go to the bottom left and you would click on the account button and you would choose Show Inactive Accounts, and you'd be able to see the two accounts that are inactive. If you wanted to reactivate the account, you would click on it and you would either click the button in the bottom left, because that would give you the ability to make the account active, or you could click on the account to choose it and then right-click and get the same choice, Make Account Active. So if you don't mind seeing extra accounts that we are not using, you can leave these two accounts as active. I, however, would like to make them inactive because I would like to have on our chart of accounts, or I would like to see on our chart of accounts, only the accounts that we physically create. Here are the accounts that we will put in for Hattie's Convenience Store. She has such a simple situation that she only really needs 6 accounts in her chart of accounts. It's very easy to add these accounts, but there's something you must know when you're adding new accounts in the chart of accounts. When you put the accounts on the account list, you must put more than just the name. You can put any name you want, and QuickBooks will allow you to spell the name of the account in any way that you want. However, you cannot save an account in the list or the chart of accounts unless you also tell QuickBooks what type or what kind of account that is. Each of the accounts will have a different type or a different kind of account, and you will see the reason for that in a moment. So there will be a field for you to type in the name, but when you choose the corresponding type, when you choose the type of account that goes with that name, what you will see is a preset pull-down menu that has the list of the account types. You must choose one account type for each of the accounts in your chart of accounts. So when you go to type this in, you can pause the video in this position. Make sure you type the name into the name field as exactly as it's spelled here. Remember to make sure that it's all in capital letters. In our course, every time we are the ones to add another account, we put it all in capital letters. This will help show us that this is an account that we added to the chart of accounts and not QuickBooks. Because when QuickBooks adds an account to the chart of accounts, it's mostly in lowercase. So if we add the accounts in capital letters, it will be easier for us to see which accounts we added and which accounts QuickBooks added. The account type we choose will determine how the account will behave. The account type we choose will determine what financial statement it will be on. For example, the account cash in Chase Bank, we need to put as a bank type of account. Why do we have to choose a bank type of account? Because if QuickBooks knows that this is a bank type of account, QuickBooks knows when we open the window to make a deposit, this is the specific account that will go up, not the others, not delivery expense, not daily cash sales. When we physically make a deposit, it's the bank type of account that goes up. QuickBooks knows this by the account type, not by the name. Same thing with writing a check. When we open a special window just to write a check, QuickBooks knows that the account that will automatically decrease is the bank type of account, regardless of what name we assign to it. We will learn more about account types in later videos. However, QuickBooks also needs to know which financial statement the account will go on. If the account is a bank type of account, QuickBooks knows it should be listed on the balance sheet when you run the balance sheet report, and this account should not be listed on the income statement when you run an income statement report. So, when you go to put in your chart of accounts, after you type in the name in capital letters, you'll probably type the name in capital letters after choosing the corresponding type for that bank account, for that account. Let's take a look. In the bottom left button of the chart of accounts window, click account, and the first choice is new. Now, the first window that opens up requires that you choose an account type before you actually type in the name. The first account type on our list was bank. Now, once you click the account type, QuickBooks is giving you a little explanation of that account type. And that's all you do in the first window of Add New Account. Just choose the account type and click Continue. When you click Continue, you get the traditional Add New Account, which was the normal window that we used in the older versions of QuickBooks. Notice the bank type of account is already chosen in this window because that's what you chose in the previous window. You still have the opportunity to change it before you save this specific account. Click in the name field, make sure that your cap locks is on, and type in cash in Chase Bank. That's all you have to do. When you click save and close, Click no for any kind of advertisement that QuickBooks might sell to you, and then you will see Cash and Chase Bank has been added to the list. Let's do another one. Account, new. The next one on the list is an income type of account. Click continue. When you get to the second window, notice income has already been chosen as a type of account. And of course, you could always change the choice before you type in the name and save it. We will type in daily cash sales. Daily cash sales. Now, if you click save and close, it closes the window and you can look back in your chart of accounts to make sure the name and the type is what you have. However, you do not have to keep doing that each time. If you are putting in several expenses at once, you can click continue and just leave expense as the account type. Now we can type in delivery expense. And we do not have to click save and close because that would save the account on the list but close the window. In this case, it would be better to click save and new, and we can see the account is added to the list without wasting time to reopen the window. Leave expense as the type and type in electric expense. Save and new. I believe we had repair and telephone expense also. So we will type in repair expense, save and new, save time. And the last expense was, yes, telephone expense. So, telephone expense. When we click save and close after the last one, we now have a chart of accounts with the same names and types that we have from our video. This is how we put in, delete, change, or make inactive an account in the chart of accounts.